I think this is a first of its time intergenerational retreat, and I think it's very important that it's hosted in Kenya by His Excellency Uhuru Kenyatta, because he's a champion on youth. And so we came here because he championed the cause of youth, but particularly young people. So the issue of intergenerational dialogue is important to Africa because we have the average age of African leadership as 66 years old, and the average age of the population is 25. So we have 40 years of generation gap in leadership, and we need to bridge that gap because our population will double in a couple of years. By 2050, half of the world will be African. If we don't do something about it now, we will be in a crisis in a couple of years. Why it's important for women particularly, because African women go through hardships that are particular to them, from female genital mutilation, to child marriage, to gender-based violence, to stigma around their menstruation and dropping out of school because of their periods, to not having access to education or dropping out of education. And so young women and girls go through very particular hardships. And that's why we need this mutual mentorship with the elder women, with the senior women. We need this mentorship also in leadership. So when we are in position leadership, how do we serve the gender equality cause? How do we open the space for more women to come in? How do we stand in solidarity as continent with each other? And where I stand in the African Union, there are all the frameworks for us to use them. We have the free trade area, we have the African Youth Charter, we have every single instrument that we need as young people and as young women to use it for our advantage. So I think all we need is a space like this where senior women and younger women come and have conversations that are very intimate. You know, it's a retreat, it's not a conference. So we don't have suit and ties and, you know, do speeches. We sit down in circles, we have conversations, and we really get that relationship and trust. And this is how I think we will continue at the African Union level, at the United Nations level, but women in any service of leadership, whether political, public service, entrepreneurship, every area, we want to see more and more young women in leadership. I think every young woman and young girl out there, you have to believe in yourself. There is a space for everyone. All you need to do is find your identity, find your mission, and get out there and do it.